The leaky gut gets a lot of attention, but exactly what is it? In order to talk sensibly about the leaky gut, let's first introduce some other important concepts. The first concept is that of the intestinal barrier, which is a term used to describe the protective component of the gut, shielding us against invasion by noxious microbes and toxins. Due to the organ origami that we see with the gut folding upon itself many times over and creating little projections called villi and microvilli, the intestinal barrier covers a large surface area of about 400 square meters. The intestinal barrier, in addition to protecting against microbes and toxins from entering the bloodstream, prevents loss of water and electrolytes and allows absorption of nutrients. There is a complex immune system going on in the intestinal barrier, with key defender cells that respond to microbes and other invaders, and also other cells that are activated to respond to invaders. A key part of the immune barrier is an enormous net-like structure of mucus overlying the cells lining the gut that helps to trap microbial invaders. The second concept to introduce is intestinal permeability, which refers to how easily substances pass through the intestinal barrier. Intestinal permeability is a measurable feature of the intestinal barrier, and there are some specific and specialized tests that can be done to measure intestinal permeability. There is now increasing evidence for the loss of intestinal barrier function that can occur either abruptly, for example, after a major sepsis episode, or gradually, which can lead to chronic inflammatory diseases. When the barrier function weakens and the intestine becomes more permeable, allowing microbes and toxins to pass from the gut into the bloodstream, this is known as leaky gut. What causes this leaky gut? In some cases, you may be genetically predisposed to have a leaky gut, but we know that there are a lot of modern lifestyle drivers that can cause a leaky gut. The role of diet is very important. We know that a low-fiber diet can trigger the expansion of bacteria that can break down the mucus layer of the gut, predisposing to a leaky gut. A diet high in saturated fat can change the balance of certain bacteria found in the gut, and these changes are associated with increased intestinal permeability in the colon, that is, a leaky gut. Indeed, the Western-style diet of high fat and carbohydrates is known to be associated with leaky gut. Vitamin deficiencies, particularly vitamin A and D, have been linked to an impairment of the intestinal barrier and therefore a leakier gut. Burn injuries and alcohol consumption have been shown to be linked to leaky gut. Certain infections such as Helicobacter pylori have been shown to increase intestinal permeability. Leaky gut is linked to the development of certain diseases. There is growing evidence in recent years that intestinal barrier dysfunction is linked to the development of autoimmune disorders. Leaky gut has been associated with diseases such as lupus, type 1 diabetes, multiple sclerosis, chronic fatigue syndrome, fibromyalgia, allergies, asthma, obesity, and even mental illness. I should caution that while there are associations found, we don't have clinical studies yet in humans that show a definitive cause and effect. Researchers have looked at ways to help reverse gut leakiness. Prebiotics and probiotics, which we covered in previous videos, can be used to reduce intestinal permeability and thus improve leaky gut. We know that different bacterial species have been discovered that can protect the intestinal barrier by targeting different components of the intestinal barrier system. One example of such a bacterial species is Bacteroides fragilis, which could serve as a probiotic and thus is being actively studied at the moment. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Take a look at our videos, which you can find over here, to learn more about the gut, and feel free to leave your comments and thoughts down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.